What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Daily here from Frag Nation, and today I am doing a review for you for Avalon Lords Dawn Rises. Where do we start with this game? A game I got a key for via key mailer. It looked promising. It was a real-time strategy, kind of city building slash warfare game. Had a lot of promise, kind of like a Total War game or, you know, something along those lines. And I had, you know, kind of high expectations for it. It had some good screenshots and things like that, but I quickly found out that the game is just kind of a shell right now. It's in early access, so that's something to definitely keep in mind. But about halfway through my research for the review, the game actually went free to play, lost its price tag, and the developers issued a statement saying that people were kind of wary of the game's price tag with its early access nature, and that the game was going to adopt a free-to-play style where a shop would be implemented. People who had already purchased the game would be given a credit of in-game store currency, as well as a soundtrack and some exclusive Discord invites as well. So the developers kind of policed themselves while changing this game into a free-to-play game. But is the game worth your time? Is it worth even downloading to play? I have to say right now it's kind of a 50-50 up in the air thing. This game could be a decent time killer. However, there's just a few issues with the game that prevent me from kind of recommending it to you to play and download. One of those things has to be the AI. It's very, very dumb, and it has no tactical sense whatsoever. It produces units literally the minute the game starts. The AI starts producing units and starts sending wave after wave of incoming enemies at you with no sense of formation or direction or really just tactic whatsoever. They just kind of attack the first thing that they see. If that happens to be another AI, then that happens to be another AI. If it's you, then it happens to be you. And that's kind of how the AI works in this game. Now, a lot of people will say that this game has, you know, it's multiplayer and you shouldn't, you know, bag on it for its AI. However, in the multiplayer matches, you can also have AI as well. And you run into those same issues if you're trying to, you know, do a 1v1 and there happens to be AI in there as well, then, you know, you've got to deal with the repercussions of this game's broken and buggy AI. Additionally, the graphics are not very good. They're very subpar for today's standard. There's a lot of engines out there I think the developers could have used for this game that would have been better than what they decided on here. Maybe it was a budgeting issue, something along those lines, but the game does not look very good, and its sound design is of the poorest quality. You'll hear throughout this review, in the background, repeated sounds, constant looping of sounds, and they can even loop together in a way that increases their volume. Just they become in unison, and it's just overbearing and tough to navigate when you're having your senses overloaded by this incredibly loud sound. And I've seen a lot of people, even in the developer's eye here, in the beginning of the game, you have to watch some YouTube videos. You have the option to watch YouTube videos. You don't have to watch them if you don't want to. You could skip them, I guess. But if you do watch them, you'll see that the person that they're even advertising on here plays with the sounds off of the game, probably because of that same reason. And the voice acting is not very good as well. A lot of improvements need to be made to this game before I can actually recommend it to you. Now, where the game kind of has a little bit of brilliance is just in its game design perspectives. The game has quite a few different upgrades. It has quite a few different troops. It doesn't have a pop cap limit that I really could see. It has it in the sense that you can't build more troops than you have houses. So you have to, you know, take your peasants, build up houses and farms and things like that to feed your armies, which makes sense, and I can agree with that. It's just, you know, with the lack of execution that really kind of kills this game and puts it in the place where it is. I can deal with, you know, graphics that aren't great. I can deal with sounds that aren't great. But, you know, once you get into the gameplay mechanics and you just see the same troops on each side just basically running into each other and disappearing, it kind of kills the game for me. In a game like this, the combat is so key. It's not a city-building game. It just has city-building elements to it. This is, at its heart, a combat game, and the combat is just not executed very well at all. The animations don't look good, and I think that has to be your first and foremost concern when you're making a game like this with such heavy focus on combat. It has to look good, then it has to feel good, and it needs to sound good, and it doesn't do any of those things. So it's really kind of on the fence. Like, it wants to be a good game, it's just currently not. So I cannot recommend it to you. I would say, now that it's in its free-to-play state, maybe keep an eye on it. Might be something you want to check out in the future. But as it stands right now, Avalon Lords Dawn Rises is definitely a game that needs to be in its limbo status. I wouldn't recommend a download now, but keep an eye on it. If it gets some quality improvements and some good updates, then I can see this game being worth the download. However, then you get into the kind of scary features of what's going to be on the free-to-play system, what's not going to be on the free-to-play system. That stuff kind of concerns me. And one other thing I wanted to address before I score the game and end the review is the modes. It's got several different modes, two of which are PvP related, and one of which is an Empire mode, which kind of has a big landmass map that players battle over. However, there's not very many players, so it's a little dead in terms of that. But the idea is cool. I like the idea of a big landmass and players inhabiting that landmass and being able to attack each other and gain and lose territory. That idea is good, along with most of the ideas in this game. It's just, you know, poorly executed. So with that, for Lords of Avalon, which I gotta say, I'm getting is that a Step Brothers 2 reference? I think I don't know. Maybe I'm just not into the fantasy stuff like some of you guys is. What is Avalon? I've heard that quite a few times. Maybe we got some copyright infringement here. I'm not sure. In any case, Lords of Avalon is gonna score a 4 out of 10. And in its current state, we will do updates to this review as it leaves early access, as we do with all of our early access games. We look forward to seeing you guys on the next video. Please leave a comment below if you've heard of this game or have played this game, or you have any kind of opinion on the footage that you've seen so far. Be happy to talk with you guys down there. Thanks so much, and we'll see you next time on Frag Nation TV.